Now, before we go ahead, I should probably tell you about one very important thing. I've called these objects the white dwarf, the neutron star, and the black hole. Ends, or what happens after the death of a star. But you'll see beginning now that nothing really ends. These stars are really as active as any other star. Of course, they are not stars like which are having nuclear reaction inside, but in other ways they are extremely active. For example, the white dwarf is formed without an expansion of a supernova. But white dwarfs, which are often in binaries, that is combination with another star, end up as supernova, because the white dwarf, being a highly dense object, absorbs material from the companion star, and when the material becomes sufficiently large to start nuclear reaction and explosion, it will explode again like a supernova. These class of supernova are called supernova 1A, and these are the ones that are providing what is called a standard candle in cosmology. That is, these supernova have a fixed amount of luminosity, and so because of that, by looking at the apparent luminosity and knowing the absolute luminosity, you can find out the distance of the object. And the supernova 1A distance is what has told us that matter has something called dark energy, into which we will not go into in detail now. But this supernova 1A, which produces this standard candle, is again something in which white dwarf takes part. Next slide, please. Now let's go on to the pulsars or the neutron stars. LGM, what do I mean by LGM? LGM stands for little green men. Because when neutron stars were discovered, not very long ago, 1964, I remember, 1968, I remember I was in Chicago at the time, and I had discussions with many people, including Chandra, about the discovery. A girl student of Huish, who was given the Nobel Prize for discovering it, Jocelyn Bell, was looking at the sky and found that there were signals which were coming repeatedly at extremely precise intervals. And since we were expecting signals from aliens or other civilizations, people thought this were probably signals being sent by other civilizations. So the whole thing was put into secrecy, government was informed and all that. But finally it turned out that these are really no signals from aliens, but these are really signals from neutron stars, because these objects, which are called pulsars, because they are pulsing at uniform intervals, are really nothing but neutron stars as we understand them now. Only the neutron star, which is made up of neutrons, is rotating very fast. And not only is it rotating, it is an extremely high magnetic field. We can easily understand the high magnetic field, because if the sun shrinks and keeps all the magnetic flux inside it, it will also have a very high magnetic field. Because the magnetic field is spread out over the sun, it is small, but once you shrink it, the same magnetic field can become very high. This high spin and the high magnetic field serves to produce these pulses. So we understand the pulses in a broad way, but the detailed understanding of these pulses is still very far away. I would suggest you ask Ratnashri, director of your planetarium, because she has worked very much in this area. But only thing to remember is neutron stars come with different ranges of magnetic fields. They can vary from 10^12 to almost 10^16 Gauss. And when they have very high magnetic fields,